So 10th class, we are to continue with CSS, and today our topic is internal style. Okay. When we were doing the inline style, we have taken the style as attribute inside the tag which we want to format. When we are to use the internal style sheet, we are to use the style tag inside the head tag, and whatever tags you want to format, you will apply the style rules on each of the required tag. Okay, like I have taken HTML tag here, then I will take the head tag. Here you take the style tag, and style tag will take the attribute type, and the value of type will be text oblique CSS. Okay, the value of type attribute in style tag will be text or CSS. Okay, one thing I want to tell you here, when you save the file in HTML, the extension is .html or .htm. When you will create CSS file, the extension will be .css, right? Now here, whatever tags you want to format, you write the selector name here and apply all the necessary formatting rules which you want to apply on that tag. For example, I have used H1 in my web page. Now, when you are to apply the style rules on a tag, do not enclose the tag in angular brackets. CSS lagate vakt tag ko aise hi rakhna hai. Iske aage angle brackets nahi lagane. Ab H1 mein kaun si properties lagani hai? Enter key, curly bracket. Okay, write here all the properties which you want to apply on H1. I want color green, right? Semicolon. I want font family as Arial. Okay. I want to make it appear bold, right? Then I want it in italic. Clear? Then I want to apply the font size here for 50 pixels. This is the last property I want. So close the curly bracket. So like this, inside the style tag, you will create the CSS part. You will apply the style rules for every required tag which you want to format. Aur aap dhyan se dekhiye, style tag I have used inside the head tag. Okay, next I want to format, let us say paragraph tag. I want to format the paragraph tag. Color, I want to take blue. Font family, I'll be taking Rockwell. Font size of the paragraph, I'll be taking 30 pixels. Then you want to set the alignment. To set the alignment, the property is text-align. Okay. If you want to set the alignment for your data, the property is text-align. Okay. Then you can apply. Color is done. Font family is done. Font size is done. You can apply font weight. bold. Okay, clear? Then you can apply one more property here, word spacing. Word spacing should be 20 pixels, right? So these are the tags, these are the selectors which I want to format. Okay, now here close the style tag and here close the head tag. Now here start your body tag. Of course you want to format the body tag also, so you can apply the background color to the body tag. Background color, you can take the color as gray. Okay, right? Now after this, when you will start the, after closing the head tag, you will simply write the coding. अब यहां पर आपने कोई और एट्रीब्यूट नहीं लगाने, डायरेक्ट टैग लगा के अपना बस कोडिंग बनानी है. जैसे पहला टैग है H1, ओके, एंड आई एम गिविंग द हेडिंग COVID-19 सेफ्टी measures. Okay, and I close the H1 tag. Isko center mein bhi le aao. So in order to bring in the center, you can write the property text align colon center. Okay, now here you write the paragraph tag. And in paragraph tag, you type the paragraph as we all know, second wave of COVID-19 or we can simply say, as we all know, COVID-19 is spread. So we should all take proper safety measures in order to protect ourselves from this pandemic disease. We should wash our hands frequently with soap, use good alcohol-based sanitizer, eat healthy and fresh food and fruits. So that is the end of the paragraph. Okay, now here I close the body tag and here I close the HTML tag. Okay, now see carefully, I have not applied any attribute here. Here I have just written the simple coding, because already I have applied all the necessary style rules above in the style tag, right? Now save this web page. I'm saving the web page inside the documents. 10th A CSS internal style .html. Okay, so let us see the browser view. This is our coding. Open with Google Chrome. Let us see the browser view. The process is taking long time. Okay, is the browser view visible? Yes, class, is the browser view visible? Rahul, Arpit. So this is internal style sheet. Now see one more thing I'm going to do. You have this paragraph, okay? Or let us say the heading. I can enclose my heading within the border. The way you have table border, I can enclose my heading inside a border. So what are the properties related to border? First of all, border width 6 pixels. Okay. Border color, I am taking yellow. Now let us take lemon color. And border style. There are so many border styles. Like for example, first is groove. I will tell you all the possible names which border style contains. Okay. So you will notice a border will appear around the heading. See. The border color is not, lemon is not coming. Let us say lime color if comes. Yeah. Have you noticed the appearance of the border? Yes. Aditi Narula, no response is coming. Aditya, no response. Arpit, Naina, Saharsh, Simarleen, Tarundeep, no response. What are the other styles a border can take apart from groove? Ridge. This is ridge style. I increase the size of the border so that you can see it carefully. This is ridge. Then let me give the color here. Yellow. Then the next style you can take is dash. Clear? Next style can be dotted. Next, you can have inset. Okay. Then similarly, you can have outset. Clear? So like this, you can apply as many properties as you can. How the question of CSS comes? You will be given one web page like this. आपको ऐसा एक वेब पेज दिया होगा और नीचे इंस्ट्रक्शंस में बताया जाएगा किस चीज को कैसे फॉर्मेट करना है. Like suppose heading COVID-19 safety measures to be having the following properties: face, aerial, size this, color this, border this, like this all. So you have to frame the coding like this. If they will ask only the CSS portion, you have to create this much coding only, which I have shaded. If they will ask complete web page, then you have to make frame the entire coding, entire web page, right? Then if in the question, it is not mentioned that what method you are to apply to create CSS, whether inline, internal or external, then you are free to use any method. But if particularly the method has been mentioned that you are to frame it with external coding only, then it is particular that you have to create the coding based on external style sheet only. Then you can't use any other style. Am I clear, class? Any doubt? Any doubt? So you can see this word spacing I have given here, 20 space between all the words of the paragraph, right? Similarly, you can specify letter spacing also, like I'm giving here, letter spacing. I'm giving 10 pixels, or let us say 15 pixels, right? See, 15 space between each letter of the word. C or U mein difference dekho, 15 letters. 15 pixels का difference है. Is it clear? Internal style sheet is clear to everyone? Okay. Then you can set the margins also. Suppose you want to set up the margins of the page. So there are four margins: margin top, margin left, margin right, margin bottom. Okay, you can set the margins also. Now let me show you the other properties of CSS. Okay. I'll be discussing more properties with you. Right now, I have used all the properties which are most frequently used. Is the MS Word file visible? Yes, students. All right. Yeah. Then come font variant is there. Font weight, font size. Yeah, see this coding. Heading is quote of the day. Thought is, it's never too late to start over. If you were not happy with yesterday, try something different today. So we are to make this web page by framing the CSS properties using internal style sheet. So this is the sample screenshot which I have pasted. H1 mein maine ye properties lagayi hai sari, aur paragraph tag mein maine ye properties lagayi hai, aur niche maine simple sa text likha hai. So this is the output of the browser, right? Now there are certain properties related to text, like text align I have discussed. If you want to have alignment of your text in left, right, top or bottom, sorry, justify or center, left, right, center and justify, then you can set the text align property. These are the four values of this property. Then indentation, you understand, in ninth class you have done this indentation, right? How much text is at far from margin, right? So you can set the value of text indentation also. Then text decoration. Text decoration, if you want to underline your text, like suppose I want to underline the heading. So I'll be taking the text decoration property. Text decoration underline. Okay. So you can underline your heading. See here, heading got underlined. So text decoration property has four values: underline, overline, line through text, blinking text, right? Then word spacing is clear to you. Space between words. Letter spacing is space between letters. Then text transform. You have typed the text in lowercase, but you want when text get displayed, it should get display in uppercase. So you can apply this property, text transform, and you can give four values here: uppercase, lowercase, capitalize, none. Like I show you here. You can apply a property, text transform, capitalize. So let us see the browser view. See, in the entire paragraph, there are so many words. Every first letter of the word, every first letter of the word is capital. Every first letter of the word is capital. Rest of the words are small. As ka A capital, V ka W capital, all ka A capital, no ka K capital. Every first letter of the word is capital. Rest are small letters. This is capitalized case. Okay? This is the case of capitalization. Right? Am I clear with it? 10th class lecture is clear.